What is the cause of disharmony in relationships? What causes emotional or even physical violence in relationship? Is it just karma or are there other?
Yeah, well, Yuraj, at the root of every nonsense behavior that human beings do is viruddha karma. It's really that's it, including diseases. At the root of all diseases is viruddha karma. Because nobody comes here to be sick, nobody comes here to be unhappy, nobody wakes up with this goal. Hey, let me see how unhappy I can get before 10 a.m. Nobody sets these kind of goals, right? It's happening even though you don't want it to. That's what karma is. Things that are never in your hand. Kara, ma. Never in your hands. So, kara is hands and ma is never. That's what karma's secret meaning is. Nobody will tell you this. Okay? So, why are all these things never in your hands? They're just getting out of hand. So, you need to remove them, you know? Here's Shashank giving me feedback. Those tools are great. It sorts out almost any issue. It does sort out any issue, man, not almost. So that's how powerful these tools are. You know, it's not almost any issue. It sorts out any issue, whatever it is. You'll get back on your prarabdha karma and you'll be like, okay with it. See, our only problem is our emotions. There's no other problem. How we feel, when we feel negatively about something, it's like physical pain. The same areas that cause physical pain in the brain, which get triggered when you have physical pain, get triggered when you have negative emotions. So what you're essentially feeling is such pain when you have negative emotions. And if that pain is really intense, it can generate morphine in your body, endorphin. Endorphin is endomorphine, right? Which is produced inside the body. So it produces morphine in your body. You know what morphine is, right? It's a painkiller. Yeah. So it also makes you high. Ha, 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 ha. So people get addicted to pain. Have you seen people who enjoy pain? After a while, pain makes you high. And it makes you high like nothing else. Heroin, morphine, these are all the same class of chemicals. You know, and they, all these amines, I think. No? Fiends. No, I don't know. You should know what they are.
I never forgot.
What is this class? Yeah, this INE, things ending, cocaine, heroin.
So they are, I think, different. I'm not sure. I'll have to look up the structure. Then
I thought they were all like one class of chemicals. Anyway, whatever. I may be wrong. I'm not a chemist. But these things are like drugs. Pain is like a drug if you get enough of it. Yeah.
That's how you get sad songs. I was thinking about it. How much pain do you have to be?
I open YouTube and I'm afraid to listen to the songs because so much crying and whining, like I can't listen, like everyone's whining. And even if it's instrumental stuff, they're whining on the instruments. So it's like so painful. Like I have to really excuse my music. I'm only listening to like Jay Uttal playing Om Namah Shivaya because he's really feeling it. And that's what's happening over here. Kushagra has this to say. These tools have been helping me to live happily with inner peace, both personally and professionally, no matter what is happening around me. Yeah, so here's another guy in a storm of negative shit happening in his life, right? And he's able to handle it because it's just a storm of shit. Like there's a shit storm in his life and he's still able to handle it because of the tools, all right? Yeah, so amphetamines, yeah, maybe Shashank, I don't know. I've never really bothered so much to look it up, so let's not bother about it. Anyway. These are things you don't do. Like, you don't need to do a PhD in what they are to know that, I should not have so much emotional pain that I start getting high on it. Then there's no end to it. Then there's no end to it. You will go and drag yourself into relationships.
Yeah.
And it's runanubandha mostly.
You can write good songs without being in pain.
I have a poetry account. I wrote more than 500 poems without pain.
Yeah.
You can mind it, you can do it. Yeah. It's called Ashwin Chekhova. Please follow it on Instagram. There's so much of poetry I've written, not even one has pain.
Yeah, I've been following it. It has been on for like 3 years now, 2 years, 3 years.
Yeah, for 3 years. Yeah, more than 500 are over, I think. I don't know. I'm nearing 500 poems. my goal was to write 1,000 poems and write one every day, but you know, I only get inspired when there's something inspirational happening, and there's very little inspirational stuff happening. So my poems have become few and far between. But in the beginning, I was in a lot of pain when I started writing those poems, but I was just laughing at the pain. So all the poems are me laughing at the pain, saying, look at this shit, look at this shit, look at this shit. And other people's pain too. Like, I can't take anyone's pain seriously because I feel that's not necessary. And people get very annoyed when you don't take their pain seriously, you know. So then I have learned to honor it and give them the words that they need to hear at that point. And afterwards, when they're feeling better, patak. So they, you don't listen. You cannot have any kind of spiritual progress with pain. It has to go. It's not happening with that. You got to feel good if you want to progress spiritually. There are many religions who ask you to go through pain in order to progress, and run from them.